First of all, I'm standing by Yosef Hafarish aside of books. We were talking about the fact of this. So, we can use the books to be in the literature, but use the technology to study with it.
So, you're saying you agree with it as a side note? As a side note?
That's our claim from the beginning.
Your argument from the beginning is as a side note.
Yeah,
it's complete source. It's accessible. It's not deep in the term. It's not necessary. No, even without it, it will still be as efficient. They just add something else.
It's needed
as I don't understand it.
No, it's needed
because if it's a side note, if it's an accessory, we don't need an accessory.
We need it for the customized programs that use complex algorithms to help us like study, to help us market students by themselves, and then create custom programs for each of them to allow them to develop their skills. Not as the necessary format that we may use back home.
But one of these technologies is a complex algorithm. Do you often refer to like a calculator helping students out?
No, I mean, I'm referring to like Khanakhani.com, which gives you certain videos as required by you.
As you order them, right?
You pick them. They order them, they give you the ones that help you develop the skills you need.
Now, who is sending those videos? A teacher or the computer? The teacher. The teacher is the main person.
The computer analyzes your skills and gives you videos that are appropriate for your life.
Okay, we
can not using that technology.
You can also hire a tutor who will come to your house the same way you're doing that.
Well, why should I expand my computers when I can build a website that will be used by many?
Because a website like that, which is also called www.uteacher.com, which provides you a special teacher for anything, actually costs a monthly subscription of $19 per month.
Can I have it free? Can I have it free? Can I have it for profit or guarantee?
You say that, however, Khan Academy also does sell things on the website, and they do also include courses for SAT, which would cost money.
Thank you so much for the time for this examination. Now time for the second argument, 12 days after the journey. Tired and uncomfortable. Now, when technology and education is introduced, and in addition to the other advantages that we've mentioned previously, e-books could be also introduced instead of printed books. Now, e-books in general are books in an electronic format that can be downloaded to any kind of reading device, such as your laptop, smartphone, or even your tablet. Just like printed books, e-books can have numbered pages, table of content, pictures, or graphs. However, e-books possess many other advantages that printed books don't. E-books put students in some state of body comfort and less impact problems since they weigh less. They are more convenient to students who can have everything they need in a single device, well organized, easy to access, and updated every now and then. In addition to that, some are more interactive and engaging. For example, some e-books contain images that can be clicked for further explanation or to view some statistics and facts. One more thing is that students tend to be more attentive and focused, which is proven in a study made by Dr. Zena Nunez-Katt, who is a pediatrician and adaptation consultant who monitored people's attention and behavior. Children lose interest. She stated that children lose interest in coming to school with the stress of carrying heavy bags. Their minds are burdened with the weight of the books, and this leads to a low attention span. She also said that carrying heavy backpacks can lead to musculoskeletal problems and is dangerous for a growing spine. Another doctor that goes by the name of Dr. Patel explained that while carrying a bag, the child has to lean forward, which leads to developing a bad posture. Now let us look at some statistics and analyze them. In a survey made by Indiebrand, which is a company that sells and reviews books, 56% of the readers surveyed prefer the e-book format and say that it contributes better in education. According to Amazon.com, during the past 2 years, e-books have outsold printed books. And this is not a coincidence, since e-books have proven to provide better features and contribute better in education. Now, regarding schools, there are many schools that started depending on technology and reduced the use of textbooks. One of them is Archie Shaw's Dependent High School in White Plains, New York. It proved that using tablets and laptops was more engaging and prepared students for college. There are many other schools. One of them is El Paso Independent School District in Texas. They said that it was a successful move that saved money. There are many other schools that said that it was beneficial and effective, such as Colgate County Public Schools and the Houston Independent School District in Houston.
Today's backpacks seem to be bulging, leaving students with a heavier, more damaged burden. All new on January 15th, news Brian McElpatton shows us how much a backpack should really weigh.
It starts in stores and continues to the classroom. Backpacks laden with heavy books and school supplies. Chiropractors say they're seeing an alarming trend.
We have some children coming to our offices at a much earlier age experiencing back pain than in previous years.
The Consumer Product Safety Commission estimates nearly 7,000 emergency room visits each year result from backpack-related injuries. California lawmakers have even passed legislation requiring schools to find methods of reducing backpack weight.
They're putting too much stuff in the backpack, and the backpack is not properly fitted to the child. This causes an increase in the curve of the spine, which also puts pressure right here at the mid back and the lower neck.
Doctors say that can lead to chronic pain and even loss of attention in the classroom.
Okay, now it's time for cross-examination brought by Rahim O'Brien.
Thanks for the appointment to my in the video about the spinal cord. Well, take a look at the doctor's book of the biology book in our school as an example. They contain about 50 chapters. The teacher only explains 2 pages per day. You can simply divide those books or photocopy those 2 pages for the day before school. Thus, nothing wrong with the doctor.
Okay. So, this will add to the value, this will add to the cost of books. So instead of getting a book that costs 400 dirhams, you will have to pay extra 100 or 200, for example, to divide the book into many chapters. And therefore, it will, therefore, not only the biology book here, which you mentioned, will be divided, but also many books. We have the calculus book, which is huge, and physics book, and many other books. However, e-books are way much less and are better. Regarding the spine and the back.
Yeah, but using e-books has the same cost of buying books and dividing them. Let's go to the second point. Did scientists like Edison, Einstein, or Newton use any e-books, use any iPads? Tell me, what laptop did Einstein use? All of those things that
right?
Yeah.
Well, this is how I like to talk about. They're placing, in order to minimize the radiation caused by technologies and devices, you can use screen filters or LCD anti-reflective surfaces. In addition to that, you can use eyeglasses that prevent radiation. So let me continue. In addition to that, you can easily adjust the resolution, brightness, text size, color temperature that comforts you and your sight. Studies also show that blinking moistens your eyes and prevents dryness. Last but not least, people who suffered from eye problems, did they use screen filters or whatever to protect their eyes? I'm assuming that they did not. No, I'm feeling too much. That's like saying 50 people got in the middle of the highway without looking at the cars surrounding them. That's 48 out of the 50 got hit by cars and died. You can generalize and say that cars are bad. Those these people didn't protect themselves.
So check on your cars. You're just letting cars. You're fixing the problem with another problem.
Statistics are showing that now, when you are using personalized technology, cost is increasing year by year. And I have a challenge.
Okay. You're addressing cost. Okay. Well, one of the schools that I addressed, in which it mentioned that reducing technology saves money, says that a switch to digital textbooks will save money over time, in which they provided 15,500 students with different mobile devices that costed them about 1.5 million per year, including warranties, insurance, and cases. However, this school would have spent 1.7 million on science textbooks that fall only, saving about $100,000. So this shows and proves that introducing technology saves money, but it does not pay.
No, it does not. What if it's not perfect, it's not efficient? What if this
is not efficient?
What if the new iPhone Pro or the iPad Pro in the ground? Also,
if you get the iPad, you'll have to even pay extra for
you'll have to pay extra for the applications needed to store the robot. Another result that came from the integration of technology into our education is that it exposes students to bullying and cyberbullying. Researchers have shown that students are using their financial stakes as a weapon for bullying. By allowing students to bring their own pieces of technology into school, you're basically giving them a weapon. You're basically giving them another weapon to use against other students. Let's say that a student that comes to school with a great Macintosh computer. He's bound to use that computer and his financial state against another computer using, let's say, a cheap Toshiba computer. That is for the bullying. For the cyber bullying, it is no mystery that computers or technology is being integrated more and more into our educational systems. And that means that we're using more and more internet. As you use more internet, that means that you're using more social media such as Facebook, Twitter, and probably even YouTube. And that will expose us to cyberbullying. Recent research done at the university, at Seton Hall University, shows that 80% of students have reported been cyberbullied through social media means. Cyberbullying has been linked to depression, and depression means deterioration. Depression results in the deterioration of academic progress. Do you really want your I ask my parents now? Do you really want your students, your children, to suffer under your nose, and you don't even know it?
Thank you.
quiet because the teams need to concentrate. 5 minutes for the emergency. Thank you.